Hello everyone, myself Kunal and I am again here with a new topic, e-diplomacy. Let's come to the topic. What is the meaning of e-diplomacy? We have seen different video conferencing which was being held during this time. As we have also witnessed India-Australia video conferencing, that is a part of e-diplomacy. So e-diplomacy can be defined as a diplomatic channels being organized with the help of electronic media. Okay? So let's see what is the prospects of e-diplomacy. Like in the time of pandemic, e-diplomacy has played a major role all over the world when there is a traveling ban. Okay, so it helps in having a mutual cooperation between the other nations. Okay, like we have also witnessed SAARC summit, G20 summit, WHO meeting, UNSCA assemblies, everything which was being held with the help of video conferencing. That is also a part of e-diplomacy. But there are some challenges also. Like leaders often hesitate to discuss about some important issues on this video conferencing, as there is always a threat of hacking or cybersecurity. But human to human contact is the best way to discuss anything and to resolve any dispute regarding anything, border or anything else. So there are lots of benefits as well as constraint regarding e-diplomacy, but having something is better than nothing. So in this time of pandemic, when there is no any source available for diplomatic channels, this is the best way, I think. So this is all about my topic. Signing off, Kunal Sawant. Thank you. Please like, share and comment.